Welcome back, guys. You're watching Entrepreneur, and in this video we're going to be going over the daily cryptocurrency news and updates on price for the day. So if you guys are new to the channel, remember to subscribe and also turn on post notifications as we put up daily cryptocurrency videos helping you guys identify the trends as well as news and other trading tips. So if you're interested in any of that content, definitely think about sticking around. Getting into the video today, we're looking at a $6,291 Bitcoin as it dropped about a little over 3% in the last 24 hours. So across the board, you guys can see the prices here. Altcoins really taking a hit. If you'll notice, Bitcoin's obviously been at these levels throughout the past couple months, but altcoins are reaching levels that they have not reached since, you know, 2017, late 2017. I remember seeing Cardano last time it was at this price, November, October, 2017. So a lot of these altcoins are taking a huge hit from Bitcoin's price variations that have continued to happen within the last, you know, few weeks to a month. So jumping into some technical analysis, I do think we're at a good spot here with the recent drop to 6,100. I think we had a nice bounce off 6,100, and we're now holding a solid level of 6,250 around that level. So if you actually jump in here, you can see that we bounced off 61. So here is the spot where we kind of bounced off right here. Sorry, I had gone a little farther, too far back. Zoom in here for a 5-minute chart so you guys can see a little more clearly. As you can see right here, we bounced right off that point, and now we're holding a really nice support around, you know, 6,200, 6,250, a little bit above the support that we bounced off around 6,130, 6,100. So we did bounce off of support. We reached that oversold signal on the day chart, and usually when we reach that, we usually see momentum start to build up towards the, you know, towards the buyer side. So hopefully we can get a reversal here if we can hold. However, the momentum is still continuing towards the downside. We don't really have any news to prop up the price of Bitcoin, so I'm okay to see the price fall a little bit more. Overall, guys, I am a little bit more bearish than bullish on Bitcoin right now, just due to the fact that the ETF decision did get postponed, and I don't think there's a lot keeping people from selling off their Bitcoin and waiting for lower prices. So if my recommendation to you would be to kind of hold off, kind of see what's going to happen first, possibly take a small position on Bitcoin or some of these other altcoins, because I do believe there is a possibility of going to move smaller levels. I apologize for that, guys. I'm a little late to my daily stream for our private group, but I wanted to get this video out first. So jumping into some of the news stories today, not a ton on news that we really have. What I did want to talk about is what others are saying about Bitcoin and altcoins responding to key supports. Okay, so Bitcoin price declined and tested an important support near 6,6100. So that's what we were just looking at. Ethereum tested 350. Chainlink and Z Classic are showing positive signs with more than 10% gain. So a couple coins that are still doing well, but let's get into Bitcoin specifically. So Bitcoin price failed to hold the 6,250 support and extended losses towards the $6,000 handle. Bitcoin USD found support well above 6,000 and is currently consolidating losses with tiny bullish moves. However, Bitcoin buyers are facing many challenges on the upside near the 6,400 and 6,500 levels. Only a successful daily close above 6,500, the previous support, could open the doors for a larger recovery. So on the downside, the $6,000 support zone holds a lot of importance and must prevent more decline. So, you know, other people feel the same thing. I also agree with this, you know, very, very much. I mean, if we get below 6,000, I think we're really opening the doors to levels we have not seen this year at all. I think it's, you know, if we push down below these levels again that we've already been at before, you have to realize we've been at these levels 1, 2, 3 times in the past, you know, 9 months, 8 months. So with that said, how many times can we really hold it, especially with nothing really holding the market up? I'm not sure if the market deserves the valuation that it has right now, especially with the SEC postponing the decision on the ETF. Like I've been saying, guys, I think there needs to be a catalyst to bring this market back and start to allow it to mature even more and grow as an entire market. Looking at Bitcoin specifically, though, this is what drives the market, and I think we need to see something that is going to allow Bitcoin to have that growth, as well as, you know, continue, give that growth and provide that growth for altcoins as well when we do see Bitcoin start to flourish. So not a ton of news, guys. Like I said, we don't have a lot holding Bitcoin up. We're still seeing great news regarding large companies and everything like that, but besides that, we don't have a lot of news. This is one news story I did want to talk about. The SEC will decide on 9 Bitcoin ETFs in the next 2 months. I think this is crucial, and I think this is that catalyst that we need. However, 9 different ETFs, if the majority of them get denied, I think that's going to be very negative for the market in general. So SolidX, VanEck proposal is obviously postponed, but there are also some other submissions as well. So coming down here, the deadline for a decision on 2 funds from ProShares is August 23rd. So that's actually coming up pretty soon. It's just 2 weeks away. The rule change paving the way for those products was submitted by the New York Stock Exchange ARCA on December 4th, 2017. September will see a series of deadlines for Bitcoin ETFs starting on September 15th, the date by which 2 funds by Granite Shares will receive a thumbs up or thumbs down. The funds were initially proposed on January 5th, the deadline for directions for funds in September 21st, as indicated by public records, after being first submitted on January 4th. And as CoinDesk reported, the SEC punted its decision, we already know that, for SolidX and VanEck until September 30th. So I know I said a few times in the last few videos, it is possible, because there were some news stories, it's possible that they will use their power to postpone this to, you know, the beginning of 2018. But with 9 different proposals that they have to decide on, I don't think they're going to postpone all of them. If any, I think we're going to see decisions. So I'm going to look for what's the decision on the first couple. If we see positive decisions on the first couple, I think we're going to be in the green and we can continue to, you know, be bullish on this market. But right now, there's really nothing holding this market back from moving to lower levels. So that I want that to be something you guys really think about when you go and look at Bitcoin's price and consider investing at these prices, because I do think there is a large possibility that we could possibly see even lower prices than what we're seeing right now. I'm talking, you know, 5,700, 5,800, and then once we break below that, I mean, it really opens the doors to 5,000, 4,500, 4,000, lower levels that we have not seen yet in 2018. So I want you guys to keep that in mind. However, with the ETF decisions, I think that's something very important to pay attention to. If we can get positive, positive thumbs up on all of those decisions, I think this market's going to be starting to bounce back towards the end of 2018. And hopefully we'll start to see the beginning of that bull run in the end of 2018. So something to think about. Let me know what you guys think on all of these ETF decisions. Will they pass them? Will they not? Will they pass some? Or are they going to deny a few of them and just pass a few of them? I'm really not too sure. I think they will pass them if they don't postpone them, which I don't think is that likely anymore, because the market has matured. I think the market is ready for this. And I think seeing all these different proposals, I think they do realize that this is not a bad thing. So let me know what you guys think in the comments. But again, if you guys are new here, make sure to think about subscribing, sticking around for more videos. We go over technical analysis on Bitcoin and different stories on cryptocurrency every single day. So if you guys are looking to get that type of content, definitely think about sticking around. But thank you guys for watching this video, and I will see you guys tomorrow.